Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did two derivations which was based on the work done during isothermally and irreversibly expansion of a gas and work done during isothermally and reversible expansion of a gas. So based on that thing, what we have got to know it as work depends on the path. How? Let me explain you by this. So now we are going to discuss that how work is a path function. So for that instance, let me consider a few things. That is, we have to consider a system of a gas, that is the same thing that we have did in our earlier lectures, and that is the system of the gas goes from the initial state where its volume is V1, that is this case, and to a final state of a volume, that is V2, till this case. But to reach the volume V1 till volume V2, there are different paths or there are different conditions from where we could let the volume V1 to V2. And because of that, we know that the work done during the expansion of gas is nothing but a pressure volume work. That is, it depends on pressure as well as it depends on the volume during expansion of a gas. So in this case, we could reach or we could let the change in volume, that is from V1 to V2, by different paths. So therefore, these are the paths that I have been mentioned in this diagram, in this small diagram, which says that this is A, that is a state, initial state, which has a volume of V1, and the final stage is B, which has a volume of V2. And these are the path, that is the path 1, where there should be change. When the work has been done through path 1, the work is been done through path 2, and this is the third one. So what are these paths? Let me explain you. For that, I've considered path 1 is the one which is in vacuum condition. So what does this talk about? It says that the system is allowed to expand freely in vacuum from V1 to V2. So again, yes, for change in volume, so as to make the change in volume, that is from V1 and V2, what I could do is I could go for a condition that is vacuum. If I apply vacuum, that is when the pressure is basically zero, that is I have written here, when the pressure is been zero, that is in vacuum, then we know the formula, that is W is equals to minus PEX into V. And in this case, suppose if the pressure is zero, then no work will be done because the work will be itself zero. Overall equation will be zero. But in any case, when the work is zero, the one thing is for sure that we have converted the volume, that is from V1 to V2. So that makes the volume to be a state function. It depends on the state, that is initial and the final. That's why the volume is a state function. But when we are talking about the work, in this case, as you could see, this is the path that have take place for path A. The volume has been changed, but in this case, no work is done. So now let us talk about the second path. So this is the second part that I'm going to mention. So it says that suppose the system is expanded from volume V1 to V2 against a constant external pressure at a constant temperature. So the work done during that process, because we did a derivation on this earlier also, suppose if we are applying an external pressure that is nothing but a constant value, it will remain constant throughout the whole process. So in that case, what happens is W is equals to minus PEX into dV. So this dV, this delta V is nothing but V2 minus V1. So means there is a change in volume, that is from V1 to V2 or V1 to V1. So the volume changes. We could let the initial stage, that is V1, to the final stage as V2. So in that case, the work will be also be the main reason that it depends on the volume also. The more the change in volume means more the work will be done. So in this case, as we could see, yes, there is change in volume, but yes, the work is also being done. So this is nothing but we are discussing about the path 2. So now let us move on towards the next one, that is path 3, because there are different conditions where we could obtain work or where we could change the volume V1 to V2. So now talking about the last one, that is path 3. Suppose the system is expanded from the volume V1 to V2, but under isothermal and reversible condition. So this is what we are talking about maximum work. That we have did a derivation on this also, and we have got to know that the work done in this process is nothing but Wmax is equals to minus 2.303 nRT log of log to the base 10. Actually, this is nothing but log to the base 10 of V2 divided by V1. So there is a change in volume, that is V1 and V2. But in this process, what happens is we are making it in a reversible condition. So in this case, the work will be obtained, that is true, but the work will be maximum, and this will be greater than that of the W that we have obtained in a reversible in an irreversible process, because the irreversible process gives a data of W equals to minus PEX into V, where the work is being obtained, but that is not maximum. But in this case, the work is being obtained, and that is the maximum value. So by observing these three things, we could easily say that the work make changes in the volume, but yes, the work depends on the path also. If it is under vacuum, this path will be obtained, or this will go through this path. The second path, that is the normal one, when the work is under a constant pressure, and this is the third path where the work will become maximum. The maximum work has been obtained in this case. So that is why there are the three paths, and the three paths are different from each other. And moving towards the last statement, the last statement will be, the initial and final stage are same in all the paths. That is true, that is V1 to V2. But the amount of work done is different for the three paths that we have discussed in right now itself. So this indicates that the amount of work done depends on the path connecting initial and final states. So the work is dependent on the change in volume, that is true, but on which path, that is more relevant. So that's the reason work is a path function. So work depends on the path, neither on the state. Because there is a change in volume that we have observed, that is from V1 to V2 in all the cases. But the thing is, work value is different in all the conditions or in different kind of paths that we have observed, that we have mentioned in this lecture. So this clearly indicates work is a path function, not a state function. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to know this video very clearly. And yes, share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to EKEDA channel. Thank you so much.